see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? They're really saying, I love you. I hear babies cry, I watch them grow. They're like much more than I ever knew. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Yes, I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
Trying. time our eyes meet, this feeling inside me is almost more than I can take. Baby, when you touch me, I can feel how much you love me, and it just blows me away. I've never been this close to anyone or anything. I can hear your thoughts, I can see your dreams. I don't know how you do what you do. I'm so in love with you. It just keeps getting better. I wanna spend the rest of my life with you by my side, forever and ever. Every little thing that you do, baby, I'm amazed by you. Of your kiss, the way you whisper in the dark, your hair all around me, baby, you surround me, you touch every place in my heart. Oh, it feels like the first time, every time. So in love with you, it just keeps getting better. I wanna spend the rest of my life with you by my side, forever and ever. Every little thing that you do, baby, I'm amazed by you.
Friends, we are gathered here in the presence of God to celebrate the joining of this man and this woman, Donna and Stephen, in the unity of marriage. They stand in our midst this evening to celebrate in public ceremony what is already a reality within and between themselves. In so doing, they invite us to participate in the celebration of what they have discovered and nurtured together. Their relationship will continue to be an evolving partnership that will enhance their love, friendship, and respect. It is in this awareness, then, that we accept that their lives have already been richly blessed. Wilford Peterson, in his Art of Marriage, tells us, "A good marriage must be created. It involves never being too old to hold hands. It is remembering to say, 'I love you,' at least once a day. It is never going to speak angry. It is never taking the other person for granted. It is forming a circle of love that takes in the whole family. It is speaking words of appreciation and demonstrating gratitude in thoughtful ways. It is not looking for perfection in each other. It is cultivating flexibility, patience, understanding, and above all, a sense of humor. It is having the capacity to forgive and forget. It is giving each other an atmosphere in which each may grow. It is for finding room for the things of the Spirit. It is a common search for the good and the beautiful. It is not only marrying the right partner, it is being the right partner. And so, Stephen and Donna, have you come here freely into this church that the Lord may seal and strengthen your hope in your baptism? And now he enriches you and strengthens you by a special sacrament that you may assume the duties of marriage in mutual and lasting fidelity. And so, in the presence of all here, I ask you to state your intentions. Donna and Stephen, have you come here freely without reservation to give yourselves to each other in marriage?
Yes.
Will you love and honor each other as man and wife for the rest of your lives?
Yes.
Will you accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the law of Christ?
Yes.
Since it is your intention to enter into marriage, turn now, face one another, and join your right hand, and declare your consent before God and his people. I promise to be true to you in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health. I will love you and honor you all the days of my life. I, Donna, take you, Stephen, to be my husband.
I, Donna, take you, Stephen, to be my husband.
I promise to be true to you.
I promise to be true to you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
I will love you and honor you.
I will love you and honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
You have declared your consent before God and his people. May the Lord in his goodness strengthen your consent and fill you both with his blessing. For what God has joined, men must not divide.
He lost.
Lord, bless these rings which we bless in your name. Grant that those who wear them may always have a deep faith in each other. May they do your will and always live together. In peace, goodwill, and love, we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Stephen,
this ring. As a sign of my love and fidelity.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
My dear friends, let us turn to the Lord and pray that he will bless woman, so the man and woman should no longer be two, but one flesh. And you teach us that what you have united may never be divided. Father,
her husband in marriage, she asks your blessing. Give her the grace of love and peace. May she always follow the example of the holy women whose praises are sung in the scriptures. Her happy old age, grant them fullness of life with the saints in the kingdom of heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
And may the blessing of the Almighty God, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit come upon each one of you and remain with you forever. And now I'd like to introduce Mr. and Mrs. Stephen Allen Matthews.
fine.
It was quick. What time is it?
I'm okay.
Hey,
Thank you.
You look bad.
Say hi.
Say hi to the camera.
Stay good.